He's not exactly your typical 9-to-5 photographer, heading into the open waters at any hour of the day. And what he captures is stunning, beautiful, and often unknown. Whether it's the world's largest fish to what we all know as Jaws, it's simply about snapping the perfect picture for the world to enjoy. So what is it like photographing great whites? How dangerous is it? Is he nervous that his subject could be eaten alive? We wanted to know the answers to all this and much more. One-on-one with underwater photographer Juan Oliphant.
For folks joining us, tell them a little bit about your lifestyle. It's unique.
Yeah, well, I'm super blessed to be living in Hawaii. I grew up here, and it's an amazing place, but the interesting thing for me as being a shark photographer and having this passion towards sharks, it wasn't always there. I grew up as a surfer in Hawaii, afraid of sharks. And it wasn't until I became a diver and got to really connect with these animals, everything changed for me. And from that point, it's been a pivotal point in my life where I've just wanted to pretty much try and do everything I can to show a different side of these animals, you know, with my photography and the directions I've taken with One Ocean Diving and meeting up with Ocean.
You know, you do some stuff that I think people are just amazed with. I mean, you are diving with some amazing creatures. Tell me what that's like.
Well, we had this huge shark out here, you know, just last week, a great white shark, which is rare in Hawaii. And in 2005, I actually got to get in the water with a great white shark, very similar size. And it is amazing. And we've traveled around the world working with Ocean Ramsey, other shark scientists, you know, diving in cages, without cages, but with great whites. It's a humbling thing for sure. But the idea I always like to stress to get across is that they do not see humans as food. Sure, they may not be the safest animal to swim with, per se, because they do fight with each other. And you're not going to win a fight against a great white shark. You just need to leave the water, respect them, and if they don't want you there, you need to get out. But there's visually in clear water, there's that clean communication that can happen. You know, so it's not as dangerous, like, oh my God, these animals are just like gonna go out and eat people. That idea needs to go away. Like, great white sharks do not see people as a food source. Like, if they did, there'd be humans disappearing constantly as they enter the water in the areas where these great whites are at.
Do you think Jaws just did more harm than good for the survival of sharks? Do you think it really just put panic in the world, you know, that many years ago, and now everyone is just, hey, get the shark, man, they're dangerous?
Yeah, it's really sad what just that one movie is kind of done. You know, up until that point, they did a study showing that when a shark bit a person, it was labeled a shark accident. And then after Jaws, it became an attack. And then there's an idea that there's like this man-eating shark that wants to go out and target people, wants to have the taste for human blood, you know? And then that whole monster perception is really, it's demonified these people, I mean, demonized the sharks as far as villains, and people don't want to do things to help save them. And it's like, we want to try and like change the tide on that. And like getting people to care about these animals is huge, and showing that we can share the same waters with these animals and get past that fear gets people to start maybe caring and maybe love and do something to protect these animals that need protection.
Dude, let's talk about Ocean Ramsey. Oh. Here's my thought about her and you. Okay, you ready? You have made her a star. You have made her what she is. You're Shots, your video has been incredible, especially what we've seen recently all over the world, what you guys have been doing. How'd you two meet, and how did this relationship become that you guys are working together on a regular basis?
Well, I met her in 2007, and I was actively working as a photographer, trying to get amazing images of sharks, you know, and like, but at the end, it felt like people were still like, oh, that's a scary animal. It's a monster. How did you survive that? And when I met Ocean, she was just starting her marine biology, courses, and really had this passion for sharks. And it was just a connection there. And once I started photographing her with sharks, I saw people's perception changing, and it was changing super fast. And as a biologist, she had, you know, a really solid message. She's really good in front of the camera too, as far as speaking and getting her opinion out, and, you know, just getting all the information that needs to get out in a short amount of time, which is awesome. But combining that all together, my message just of trying to show that, hey, these animals aren't that bad and that we need them got a bigger reach because you're showing a human with them. And it's not just like a guy out there, like some macho how to do. It's a girl who's intelligent, she's beautiful, she has a message that she wants to share, and it just gave her that platform to do that, and I'm stoked to be able to help her get that message out, and it's the same as mine.
What would you say to all the people that'll be watching and going, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna jump in the water next time I see a tiger shark, or what's your advice to them?
The big thing for me is just always respect, you know, and take your time. Like, see, if that animal doesn't want you there, don't push it. Like, get out of the water. It's usually pretty clear where you can see that communication. Go out with an experienced guide, somebody who's got years diving with them that can read that behavior and that can kind of teach that a little bit to you. Because it's not something that you just want to just jump in the water with a huge great white shark and splashing around with yellow or white fins and, you know, and get some maybe unwanted attention, you know. So you want to be always treated more as an equal predator versus a prey out in the water. And that just comes about being comfortable and reading that behavior.
And I hope to come diving with you guys sometime. Next time I'm in Hawaii, I'm going to call you guys, and I want to go out.
Yeah, anytime you want, man. We'll get you out 100%. Yeah. We'd love to have you.
Thanks, Juan.
Yeah, thank you for having me out, or on the show at least. It was really cool.